good morning. We are up and we are ready to go to Copenhagen. It's Ironman time. I'll probably catch up with you when we get to Copenhagen, when I'm not stressed about getting through the airport security and stressing about whether my bike's gonna get there. So yeah, enjoy the vlog. See you in Copenhagen.
Here he is, the final member of the sport crew.
Of course you can.
I'll give her this. Anyone needs to
see. Hello from Copenhagen. So we are down by the water, as you can see here. What I'm going to do is get registered, and then there's like a 5k fun run, which we're going to do. I've got a bit of a run to do anyway, so I thought, why not do it as part of this little fun run that's been put on. So my brother and his girlfriend, who have surprised me, to come out here. I had no idea. So what happened was we had run away to pick up our luggage, and then my brother, well, who I thought was just a random man, came up next to me and was like, excuse me, do you know where the baggage is? And I looked at him and just screamed in his face, and then I sobbed. So that was emotional. I had no idea they were coming. I have never been so shocked. I don't think I've had many like surprises like that in my life, so it was a shock to say the least. So that was really nice. But so yeah, they're here and they're gonna do the fun run with us. So we'll do that, and then yeah, just chilling for the day. A bit tired because we're up at 3 this morning, so it has been a long day, so it will be an early night tonight. But we are here. If I turn this around, so you will see over there in the very, very distance, the swim start is over there where those white boys are, and then there's some boys, and this is a bridge that we will swim under, and then, well, it's all the way down there under that next bridge as well. So yeah, looking at the swim. Oh, actually, looking. The water looks alright. It looks quite clear, actually. Water looks good. I might do a swim tomorrow to just test out my wetsuit and test out if I can still remember how to swim. My mum probably wants to do a swim with me as well, so we'll do that tomorrow. But yeah, just lots of wandering, exploring, chilling, but a bit of activity. And tomorrow I need to make sure I eat enough. I need to eat lots of carbs. I always find it quite difficult to eat a lot when I'm like out of my normal routine, and like when you're eating at restaurants and stuff. So I need to plan a little bit more tomorrow. So anyway, here comes Gaz, ready to run. Are you ready to race?
Yeah.
Are you ready to race?
Am I ready to race?
The fun run. He's gonna win the fun run. Here's the swim start. And the swim exit over there. Jesus. It's very real now.
Is there an orange? I need a little orange carrot.
You are?
Where do I sign?
Right in the middle, as big as you can.
What do I write?
Anything you want.
Yeah.
Doesn't matter.
Why am I so awkward?
Go down the bottom.
Don't swear.
Yeah.
We got this.
Yeah, all the way.
Yeah. They're in my picture.
Oh my god.
It's mine.
That's horrendous. You pay all this money for that.
Oh my god, I should have done that. Right, here we go. Oh, my fingers are in it.
That's a really good one then.
Oh, it's a baby. go, you can count it. I know you've not done one before, so this is the first one.
Unbelievable.
Did I mention I'm doing an Ironman?
Didn't know.
Did you know?
I'll register with you, yeah. We're in. We're all in.
Go on, you're a bit. Go on. You've only got water on there. You might as well just walk through it. Go on.
Do you want to borrow my All World Athlete badge or not? I was gold, you see, that's all. I was gold, that's all. No, I think you'll be the other side then. Go, go, go. You're in. It's too late now.
You believe me? No one would be crazy enough to take my what, 1 to 104 or first one?
First one. 1 hour.
1 hour?
Yeah. You'll be sub an hour. Red cap.
Where's she gone?
Red cap. She needs to go to red cap. Yeah.
Has she gone, hasn't she?
Yeah.
She's not put a stub time on.
No, see, depending on what cap. What time you think you swim, you're going.
No, no. Yeah, no. We do it here rather than.
Yeah, then actually on the thing, yeah.
Oh, right.
That's an easy number to remember. 7, 7, 7. Easy.
Oh, the special needs?
Yeah.
Yeah, isn't
that? Take one. Put your wet kit in afterwards. I think you called her special needs. It's another bag you can, I think you can put like a load of stuff in and just leave it on course somewhere.
You want that?
Nice.
A guy behind you got 7, 7.
Oh, nice. Your rack buddy. Transition buddy.
All the transition bags are inside.
Did you go first?
Everything within your sphere. Your time in your chip. You get that. Pretty much you can do.
It's
your first time.
It is, yeah.
Oh,
it's
fine.
Yeah.
This is
a
pretty
cool. Have a nice day on Sunday.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Bye.
That's a nice bag.
Much better bag than last day. I'm ready to race. That's a map. So the run course looks long.
I think it's all pretty long.
It's only 10k.
Times 4. 10.5.
That easy, yeah.
10.5k.
Oh, is that it? God. Is there any point getting out of bed on Sunday?
No. It's 10.55. Good size.
We're fun running. Are you having fun? Guys, trying to win the fun run. Go on.
It's just part of being a CrossFit athlete. You do everything, bit of everything. Back there's nothing.
Hold on, Mum.
Matching it around. Give it an hour.
Almost there. Good morning. So I have slept for like 9 hours. I'm feeling amazing and I'm just building my bike. It's all going very smoothly so far, apart from I did put my handlebars on the wrong way around. But apart from that, we're all good. The front wheel's on, we're going to put the back wheel on. Pedals need to go on. We're winning. And then we're going to go for a swim this morning. We're going to go down to the swim start and just do maybe like 1,000 meters or something. Gaz is going to come as well. My mum's coming. It's going to be nice.
Yay! Right, pedals. I need to put the right way up to do the pedals the right way. That's practice.
As close to the military as you're gonna get, alright?
It's gonna be the outside.
You don't need this dog, yeah?
Do it not tomorrow?
No.
Just turn it, just put it down though, just in case.
Yeah, well, I'm going all the way up. Keep going.
Oh.
I'm just gonna check three gears, yeah?
It's so built. Kind of we're all good. I think we're all set. I'm going to obviously ride it later on today just to make sure that like everything is fine, just to double check. Probably do a quick spin on it on Saturday as well before I rack it, but so that was the most seamless building I've had. Minimums. Yeah, I think it's just a case of practice, just a case of doing it. So yeah, I'm happy with that. We're all good. We're getting there.
Very nice.
God. Oh, it smells amazing. Is it right to line?
I think it's right
to line. Oh my God. That's amazing. This is a good thing to carb up on.
Well, yeah, it's nice and thick, isn't it? In England, I'd say now, but.
Mm. That's mad. Look at all the layers.
Mm.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 little layers. Mmm. I'm gonna go everywhere.
Yeah?
Yeah, just saw him at 1500 metres. And it felt good.
I'm nice. Really happy.
Water's nice and smooth, nice and cold, nice and fresh. So yeah, feeling good. Prep done. That's mad in like 48 hours. 48 hours are going to be an Ironman?
Yeah.
Right? No, 48 hours on the other bike. So transition bags are all packed. They're all laid out and ready to go. Just need to go to the shops to get like some savoury stuff to put in my bike bag that's on my bike, and then in my transition bags just for something different to eat. But I think we're mostly done. I'm getting my hair braided at 11. So we're gonna get some coffee and some breakfast now, and then go to drop off the transition bags, drop off my bike. Oh my God, it's all so real now. But yeah, they're just here, all sorted. Run transition bag, bike transition bag, special needs bags, which I've not decided. Basically, they're just bags that get put out on the course for you if you wanna have extra stuff that you can grab. Tri-suit. We're ready. Oh my god, I'm terrified. I'm probably terrified. So it's a little bit later. I completely forgot to take my camera out with me to breakfast, so we just walked down sort of into the main city centre and just had some breakfast. There's a place called Grod, which translates to porridge. It's essentially just a porridge place. So we had porridge with loads of toppings on, just getting loads of carbs in. And then I've come back, Gaz has just gone to look around the shops, and I'm just chilling, trying to stay off my feet as much as possible today, which is hard for anyone who has trained for an Ironman and you're so used to doing something all the time. Like, I don't know what to do. I feel so full after breakfast because I'm so used to just like, I don't know, eating and then probably training and then feeling hungry again. So I definitely don't feel hungry. I'm very full. But yes, and I didn't even take my camera out. My brain's all over the place today, which you can imagine. I'm excited, I'm nervous, I'm all of like, I don't know, I need to unwrap my bike. Once that's done, it's fine. Need to do my transition bags. I don't know how I'm feeling. Like, I felt a bit emotional before. Oh, I don't know, like, it's the weirdest feeling, I think, because I care. Like, obviously I want to do well, I want to enjoy it, I want to, yeah, just get around it, which I will, obviously I'll get around it, but I don't know, it's a lot, like a lot of, not pressure, it's not pressure at all, because there's no pressure from anyone other than myself, no one's putting pressure on me, but I think there's been such a big build-up towards it, and I do, not that I would let anyone down, but I don't know, it feels like, yeah, I want to do everyone proud, so, and yeah, I will, I'll do everyone proud, I'll do myself proud, and I'll enjoy it, and I'll probably cry on the start line, I'll cry on the finish line, I'll probably cry today, because I feel, you know, when you just feel on, like, the verge of crying, I feel like that's what I feel like all day today, but it is just from stress and nerves. Anyway, I'm trying to chill, I'm watching some YouTube, I'm watching GTN, all the triathlon stuff on today. I'm following the PTO Singapore race as well on my phone, so that's good. And actually, I feel like I've not even done a little house tour. There's not very much to show. Let me just, so this is me. This is the front door. The bathroom is in here, like the tiniest little bathroom. The shower is there, literally that's the tiny bathroom. And then this is the bedroom, nice bedroom to be fair. And then if we go out here onto the balcony, our balcony overlooks a graveyard. That's nice. It's very quiet here in the evenings. Lovely day here today. It's really hot. My wetsuit's just drying from yesterday. So yeah, that's that. And then we've just got a little lounge in here. This is where all my transition bags and stuff are. Bike is all sorted with all my nutrition on there, and then we've just got a little kitchen in here as well. So yeah, that's our little house. I set off in 5 minutes to go and get my hair done, get it braided. So actually I'm gonna go and do that now. But yeah, just chill today. Just chill. We've done like yesterday and the day before. Obviously when you come to a new place that like, you're wandering around and everything. So the past 2 days we've done like 25,000 steps each day. So obviously I don't want a big step day like those days. I'm just trying to sit still. I've got like, I feel as though as well when you're tapering for a race, like you feel all the aches and pains, they start to come out, and I've got this weird pain. I don't know what this is. Is that a bone? Is that, I don't even know what that is. Like the outside of my calf, right down the side, down to my ankle bone. It's a weird pain, but I feel like you're just more aware of these things when you're not constantly training. So anyway, I'm not thinking about it. So yeah, that's my little update for you, and yeah, I'll take you with us when we go to transition to drop the bike off and everything. So I'll show you around the transition when we get there. Right, so hair is all done, and I feel like she didn't really know what she was doing, but it's better than what I could have done, so I'm not going to have a paddy, even though I almost did, but anyway, it's done, and we're just about to go to transition. Gaz has got my bike, and he's going to ride his stylish bike down. We're going to cycle together. This is his lovely orange bike. We're going to go rack mine, so we'll see you down there. What a day. Oh god, oh god, oh god, it's over there. What have I signed up to?
There it is. Got the finish line there.
Behind it, yeah.
Oh, that's where that horse thing is. That's where it is. So they're setting up the finish line just here. Oh God, it's all very real now. So there's like where everyone can sit, and that's the arch I'll be coming under tomorrow. Jesus. Oh God.
Have you got your stuff?
I got nuts.
That'll do, right?
I think just to break up the taste of sweet stuff, and I got some noodles. You never know what you might want.
There we go then. And where are we off now?
McDonald's.
Mackey's.
Something plain, something salty. Right, so we're just going to go into transition to drop my transition bags off, to drop my bike off, to get my chip, and then I think that's everything. I think we leave both of the transition bags down here, even though the transitions are in different places, so it's a split transition. I assume they take them up to the transition, our run transition bag. I don't know. I'm gonna find out how it all works. I probably should have read about that, but anyway, I'm gonna get my chip and drop my bike off. My nutrition's all in my bag. Tomorrow I'll just need to pump up my tyres and put my hydration on my bag, so let's go do it. Here we go, bike has been racked. This is part of transition. There's like another area over there and then another area over there. This is my little area, right near the loos, quite close to the edge of this transition line. Shit. So yeah. God. That's it. Bike racked. I'm just gonna hang the bags up now. Oh my god. So my bike is racked, my bags are dropped, and I'm ready to race. Next time I'm down here will be tomorrow when I'm swimming all the way out there. It's bloody miles. But yeah, everything's done now and now I just need to chill. We're gonna go get some food and get an early night because I'll be up at like 3:30 this morning. 3:30. Brilliant. Can't wait. And then we come down here for about 5:30 to start racing at 7:00. Good morning. It's race day. Oh my god. It's race day.
Big mixing bowl. Frosty, of course.
Thanks. Also, she only had the world's smallest bowls or a mixing bowl.
I used a mixing bowl.
I did.
I reckon she got an umbrella anywhere.
What are you worried about? Yeah. You're running, yeah.
I wasn't going to be surfing, so they're watching, yeah.
Mum and Dad have got umbrellas.
Have they?
Yeah.
Well, that's good for them.
I've had my breakfast, I've had a coffee, my bag's all packed, I've got my wetsuit in there, I've got my timing chip on, tri-suit on, got a bike pump and he's going to pump my tyres up, I've got my water bottles as well which need to go on my bike. I think I've got everything. Oh shit, we're leaving in 15 minutes! We're getting the metro down there, it's like a 15 minute walk to the metro stop. Then it's like 10-15 minutes on the metro and then it's about 15 minutes walk when we get there. So yeah, I'll go put my tyres and faff, swim warm up and then swim start.
Right.
Let's go.
We're always ahead of schedule.
We are always ahead of schedule. So it's 10 to 5 and we're walking to the metro a bit ahead of schedule because Gaz is in control of the timings. So yeah, we're almost at the metro stop now. Oh, it's getting very real. Look how calm the water is. What a morning. Oh, fucking hell.
I'm there for a swim.
I know. Why don't you come and do it?
No, thank you.
You have any final words on this stuff?
Yeah, why do I actually have a free plane?
Because you want to support me.
I do, not at 3 in the morning.
It's 5, it's half 5. What, go? From
swim
the
fast.
Ironman Pro Hotel.
Swim fast.
Okay.
Bike fast. Don't be shit.
So we can be done early. We can spend the rest of the day going.
Exactly.
Thank you so much.
Thanks for having me on your blog.
Just heading into transition, which is over there, just to pump up my tyres and just do some final checks really, but the conditions look perfect today. Wind is minimal and just like a nice temperature. So we still warm up a bit later on to like 22 degrees, which again is pretty perfect. I don't want it too hot. So touch wood, we've been very lucky with the conditions. Hopefully it won't absolutely downpour for the whole race like it did in Lahti. So yeah, winning.
One of the golden rules when you do an Ironman is to be you can enter the so if you want to do that, you can get down there from now on. And we will open the actual gate to the start at 6:50. And you will start according to the power on your suit pack. So kind of a booklet will come at you, and then it's going to be organized in 6 rows, and then we're going to start you off nice and smooth. So if you're closer to the right hip, which is the
left heel, you can zip it up the
edge. And if you want to go further away, let's say, please see.
Yeah.
No, not for that long. It was just, we thought it would take us like half an hour into the airport.
Oh, it did go wrong once.
There we go, that's what it's about. We're in today.
Beautiful. Yes, it's alright, yeah.
Perfect. Oh wow.
We're gonna get a photograph.
Hold on, that was it with a few wrong miles.
With a few wrong turns.
Would have been another. Another half an hour.
We went through Christiane.
Did you go through? Nice.
So we've had a right sightsee really.
Go on then, in you go. See you soon. You're not done, you're only warming up. Go on. How was it?
Perfect.
Yeah?
It's so nice in there. Heart rate's really high though, which is to be expected.
20 minutes.
Heart rate's high.
Oh yeah, it's going
to
be high.
I'm trying not to panic.
No, you're fine. You'll settle in.
Yeah, it's perfect. Perfect conditions. Very weedy.
Good.
But,
it won't be as weedy over there.
No, it won't be. But yeah, the goal is to just find someone fast and stick with it.
Yeah.
Laura. Okay.
See you at the finish line.
Yes. Love you, Laura. You're an Ironman.
Go and do
Come
it.
On.
Nail it.
Let's go. We're in. We're in.
I don't want to be in anymore.
You do.
I don't.
This is good.
I'm out. I'm out.
You're not. Go smash it. You don't need luck. Go careful. Go down there. See you later on. Go smash it.
We've got time, play space for you on the opposite side. And here we go, Rick Camp will be in the start booth pretty soon. They will launch in just a few minutes. Once again, spectators, we have space for you down by the beach. Next group is the orange swim cap.
Coming under the bridges, that's first person there, I don't know if you can even see it. Gaz in charge of the block today. Running around these areas.
Yes, Laura, welcome!
Come on, Laura, settle in now! Smash that, you absolutely smashed it! I thought I'd quickly film it. Oh, where do I look? Oh, there we go. Look into the eye. I've just come back from the swim. She's absolutely nailed the swim, 59.35. I had to sprint through transition because I thought she was going to be about 10 minutes, but she wasn't, she was 4.5. And then, yeah, she's out with all the age group boys. Mental. So hopefully she has a good bike ride because she'll get dragged along with them. I've just got some porridge. And I've done 16,000 steps already, just trying to follow her around. So who's actually had the bigger day, me or Laura? Figure that out in the step count later. Back out. Sunny now. Lovely and sunny. Laura's done about 120k on the bike. She's absolutely flying. And she gets to run down here soon. No one in here at the minute. Bet she can't wait to get here.
Comes.
Smashed it! Absolutely smashed it!
Keep going, Laura.
Yes! Run steady now. Just run your race. It's your race. Just nice and steady. Go on then, Laura. Steady now. Just ease into that first 10k, yeah? Well done, gang. Come on. Smashing it. Well done. You're smashing it.
Yeah.
Just keep doing what you're doing.
I can get this 150
half, and then I've got the yeah, steady. Well done. I'll see you in a sec. Go on, Laura. Over halfway now. Smashing it. Keep going. Well done. You've done all the hard work now. It's just resilience now. Grit, determination, that's it, yeah? You've got this. You absolutely smashed it. Just keep it sensible, walk the aid stations and keep going, yeah? I'll see you around the other side. Go on then, Laura. I'm here all day. Let's go. Last lap. Just enjoy it. Last one, come on. That's it. 8K to be an Ironman. What on earth? Come on. You've got this. I'll see you at the finish line, yeah? Enjoy this last 8K. Go on, go smash it. Come on then. Don't beat me there. Yes, Laura! Yes! Let's go, Laura, ring the bell! Ring the bell!
That was amazing, you did so well.
Hello, so this is future editing Laura checking in. I appreciate that ended very abruptly. I think we got to the end and we were just, we're all just so happy, and I don't think we didn't film anything for the rest of the night. We went for food and we just, I just chilled, I just hung out with everyone and just had a lovely evening celebrating, and I had a burger, I had a beer, I drank a lot of water, and then I lay awake in bed until about 11 o'clock and then slept till maybe like 3:30 the next morning. I was just still like wired after the race, absolutely wired after the race, and just, I don't know, just so excited, couldn't sleep. So that ended really abruptly, and what I've come on here to say is in a couple of days time I'll be posting the second video, which will be a full race recap of everything from start to finish, the highs, the lows, the great times, the awful times, just the whole description of the race, and hopefully, you know, give some advice to anyone who's also maybe training for their first Ironman of what to expect, and yeah, just my full experience. Obviously you've seen some clips there, and I tried to smile as much as possible whenever I saw the camera, but there were definitely some really dark times on the, especially on that run. But anyway, that will all be covered in the next video, so stay tuned for that. And a massive thank you again for watching, for supporting, and like I've had loads of comments and just lovely people that I've spoken to on here, so thank you so much. And yeah, please subscribe and be ready for the next video, which will be coming out in a couple of days time. I hope you've enjoyed this one. I hope you enjoyed watching me becoming an Ironman. Obviously got my jumper on. I'm living in all my Ironman merch for the time being. So yeah, stay tuned and thank you for watching.